Our heart and soul bring out their joy this morning. We long to meet and touch the living God. The sparrow even here has found a shelter. The swallow of fire all dust is a nest. Oh, happy those who dwell in his your temple, who day by day your praises sing, O Lord. How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord. What peace and joy to feel so close to you. Our heart and soul ring out their joy this morning. We long to meet and touch the living God.
This Mass is offered for the following intentions: thanksgiving to Sacred Heart of Jesus and Immaculate Heart of Mary. Wedding anniversary blessing for Gladwin and Brunita Pinto. Birthday blessings and good health of Geraldine D'Souza, Clinton D'Souza, Amy Fernandez. Good health and welfare of Savio and Jude DeSilva. For the souls of Frederick and the deceased members of the Albuquerque family, Charlie and Anna Barrow, Walvin and Thomas D'Souza, Maureen and Anthony Valadares. Souls in purgatory: Hendrik D'Souza, Jacqueline D'Souza and family, deceased members of Santos D'Souza and Pereira families, Hendrik D'Souza and Graciano Montero. We also pray for all those who celebrate their birthdays and anniversaries today. All together, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the priceless communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, every Eucharist is a thanksgiving to God the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. At this Eucharist, let us call to mind many blessings God has showered in our lives faithfully and mercifully. To celebrate the sacred mysteries of this Eucharist in a worthy manner, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord's pardon and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
O God, hope and light of the sincere, we humbly entreat you to dispose our hearts to offer you worthy prayer and ever to extol you by dutiful proclamation of your praise. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, a Pharisee in the council named Gamaliel, a teacher of the law held in honor by all the people, stood up and gave orders to put the men outside for a little while. And he said to them, "Men of Israel, take care what you are about to do with these men. For before these days, Theudas rose up, claiming to be somebody, and a number of men, about 400, joined him. He was killed, and all who followed him were dispersed and came to nothing. After him, Judas the Galilean rose up in the days of the census and drew away some of the people after him. He too perished, and all who followed him were scattered. So So in the present case, I tell you, keep away from these men and let them alone. For if this plan or this undertaking is of man, it will fail. But if it is of God, you will not be able to overthrow them. You might even be found opposing God. So they took his advice, and when they had called in the apostles, they beat them and charged them not to speak in the name of Jesus and let them go. Then they left the presence of the council, rejoicing that they were counted worthy to suffer dishonor for the name. And every day in the temple and from house to house, they did not cease teaching and preaching that the Christ is Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to
God. Our response is, there is one thing I ask of the Lord, to live in the house of the Lord. Kindly listen to the tune.
There is one thing I ask of the Lord, to live in the house of the Lord.
All together.
There is one thing I ask of the Lord, to live in the house of the Lord.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Whom shall I dread? Together.
There is one thing I ask of the Lord, to live in the house of the Lord.
There is one thing I ask of the Lord, only this do I seek, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze on the beauty of the Lord, to inquire at his temple. Together.
There is one thing I ask of the Lord, to live in the house of the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
At that time, Jesus went away to the other side of the Sea of Galilee, which is the Sea of Tiberias, and a large crowd was following him, because they saw the signs that he was doing on the sick. Jesus went up on the mountain, and there he sat down with his disciples. Now the Passover, the feast of the Jews, was at hand. Lifting up his eyes then, and seeing a large crowd was coming towards him, Jesus said to Philip, "Where are we to buy bread, so that these people may eat?" He said this to test him, for he himself knew what he would do. Philip answered him, 200 denarii worth of bread would not be enough for each of them to get a little." One of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said to him, "There is a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what are they for so many?" Jesus said, "Make the people sit down." Now there was much grass in the place. So the men sat down, about 5,000 in number. Jesus then took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed them to those who were seated. So also the fish, as much as they wanted. And when they had eaten their fill, he told his disciples, "Gather up the leftover fragments, that nothing may be lost." So they gathered them up and filled 12 baskets with fragments from the 5 barley loaves left by those who had eaten. When the people saw the sign that he had done, they said, "This is indeed the prophet who is to come into the world." Perceiving then that they were about to come and take him by force to make him king, Jesus withdrew again to the mountain by himself the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Dear brothers and sisters, the passage that we have just heard of, we need to regard this passage as a miracle of divine providence and a messianic sign. This passage must instill in every Christian a conviction that there is nothing impossible with God, that with divine help everything is possible. And this is what actually Jesus believed, and this is the starting point for today's miraculous journey. The little boy had just 5 barley loaves and 2 fish, and this is all that was needed for feeding 5,000 people. This little boy's generosity created a life-giving effect among everyone. Love is the requirement of salvation. And the early Christians, my dear brothers and sisters, regarded this event, feeding of 5,000, a very important event, because in this feeding they anticipated the Eucharist. Today at this Eucharist, today this passage, dear brothers and sisters, invites us to share all our blessings with the needy. And this is exactly what the early Christians did. They shared all that they had with the needy. When we share faithfully, generously, even the little or nothing that we have, it creates a life-giving effect, because God blesses our generosity. During these days, we need to check with people around and say, hey, can I do something for you? Do you need help? What can I do for you? This attitude is the need of this hour. The gospel passage also throws up 2 attitudes of Philip and Andrew. For Philip, the situation is hopeless, nothing can be done. But Andrew was more positive, and he was like, I'll see what I can do, and the rest, Jesus will do the rest. And this is what we need. We need Andrew's attitude today, a positive one, a brighter one. Amen.
Take our prayer, we ask you, take our hearts, we love you, take our lives. Oh Father, we are yours, yours as we stand at the table you set, yours as we eat the bread our hearts don't forget. We are the signs of our life with us yet. We are yours, we are yours. Take our breath, we ask you, take our hearts. We love you, take our lives. Oh Father, we are yours, we are yours.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice from thy hands to the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church.
Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your family, that under your protective care they may never lose what they have received, but attain the gifts that are eternal. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to Lord you yet more gloriously. When Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, he never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Oswald Gracious, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be.
We make an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus,
I believe
that you are present.
That you are present
in the most holy sacrament.
In the most holy sacrament.
I love you
above all things,
and I desire
to receive you
into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment,
receive you sacramentally.
Come at least spiritually.
Into my heart.
I embrace you
as if you were already there.
And unite myself.
Holy to you.
Never permit me
to be separated from you.
Amen.
I am the light, bringing you out of darkness. So come, take my light to the world. I am the bread, you must feed to the hungry, the wine that must chill every heart. Foxes have holes, birds have their nests, but the Son of Man has no place to rest. Come, follow me, be the light of the nations, leave your nets and come follow me.
For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion, Abba Father, have mercy on us and save us from the virus. For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion,
Abba Father,
have mercy on us, save us from the virus. For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion, Abba Father, have mercy on us. Save us from the virus. For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion, Abba Father, have mercy on us. Save us from the virus. For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion, Abba Father, have mercy on us. Save us from the virus. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, that redeemed by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women. And blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Alleluia, Mom, come. Pray for us. Come with us, the Lord, be king, but joy is now revealed. Now, rich by the bread of life, renewed and ready to serve. Together we have shared this meal, the bread of unity. Help us, Lord, to build a world where love and charity abide.